right, here's another one for you. Yeah, I know I make these every day. But anyway, so here's another one I was thinking about, Silux video. Silux is going to fight Samus, obviously, but at what point, we don't know. And the way I look at it, I think Samus is going to definitely 100% win the final battle against Silux, because, you know, you think about it like this. Most Nintendo games, the main characters don't get killed off. And as a matter of fact, if we think about where Metroid Prime 4 would go in the timeline, I mean, it's safe to say that, I mean, with Metroid Fusion being, like, pretty much the last game in the series, and I think that's where they wanted to end the series, because the way that the Metroid Fusion ends, they, you know, Nintendo was implying that, you know, that was kind of like a conclusion, sort of, like, Samus was talking about, like, what Adam Malevich was saying that, you know, don't worry, one of them will have to understand, because, you know, Samus pretty much blew up a top secret facility that the Federation was actually going back to, but then she would send a transmission later on saying that the place no longer exists, as well as SR388 was gone. That's still crazy how they blew that up. You know, they managed to get the BSL space station to go on a collision course right into SR388, but obviously with the 3 minutes that it took for the repulsion sequence activation, it didn't crash into the atmosphere. It just generated a huge explosion, but powerful enough to blow the entire planet up while it was probably in its atmosphere. If that makes sense. That's kind of really interesting how that works. But, I'll be honest, you know, even SR388, I always wondered, you know, the planet still existed, but then no, you know, people told me no, you know, that planet didn't exist, that whole, like, I played the game again, and that literally that huge explosion was actually the planet's death, too. I thought to myself, after a time, when you see, like, you kill the Omega Pirate, the Omega Metroid, you get on the ship, and then 3 seconds later, like, you just dead silence, and then all of a sudden, like, as you see Samus flying away in the distance. It's like 3 seconds later, you see Samus leave, and then all of a sudden, goes the planet. As well as the SR388 and the ship. But my point is, you know, this has to do with, you know, Samus is alive still, obviously. So unless, of course, somehow, you know, like, whatever trilogy we want to throw out there, say, like, Silux versus Samus, and then maybe the other Hunters, whatever the next game in the Prime series is, because, you know, you had Metroid Prime, and then, you know, some other games, or, no, wait, the Prime series ended, and then Metroid Fusion took place, if I'm not mistaken, but anyways, the Prime series takes place before Metroid Fusion. I had to look at the timeline again, but if it's true what they say, that Metroid Fusion is still the last game in the series, and Silux fights Samus way before Metroid Fusion, I think it's safe to say that Metroid Fusion, Silux is still going to fight Samus, but unless, of course, they kind of cancel the ordeal, like, when they fight each other. So, like, you know, maybe it'd be like a standstill, so, like, you know, they'll fight each other, but Silux won't be dead, but, like, maybe gravely injured or something like that. You know, I think it's safe to say that Silux will still, you know, Samus will still be alive either way. There's no way she's going to die, and then that's it, you know, no. I mean, she started her mission against space pirates, and she's still a soldier. It's kind of like if anybody remembers Ghost in the Shell Complex, that whole complex where the Major was always still alive, no matter how many times they threw bad stuff at her, that she always found a way out of it. Beat the odds, you know what I mean? Still active and on the mission. It's kind of like how Samus Aran is, you know? The same people that taught her well is the same people that will regret turning against her.